Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers, with a little bit of news about the Lakers and what their plans could be moving forward to build out this roster. Before I dive into a quick reminder, it's the busy time of year. Make sure you are subscribed right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. All right. So the Lakers reportedly, according to Dave McMenamin of ESPN, have a backup plan if this whole Kyrie Irving situation doesn't work out. My best guess is it's going to work out. I think it probably will, because it feels like Kyrie is doing everything he can to push his way towards the Lakers. And the Lakers are essentially the only team in the NBA right now that have any kind of real incentive to go bring in Kyrie Irving and the kind of stuff that he can bring with him. But frankly, he's an upgrade on the court compared to Russell Westbrook. So the Lakers do have motivation to land Kyrie. Kyrie's trying to do what he can to get there. The question is, can the Lakers get the Nets on board? But the Lakers reportedly do have this backup plan where if things fall to pieces with Kyrie, if the Nets just say, you know what, Kyrie, despite you, we're going to send you anywhere other than where you want to go, or we're going to have you sit at home, or we're going to tell you you're under contract for a year, and so you need to stay here and play it out with us. Whatever happens, if somehow Kyrie Irving does not wind up with the Lakers still need shooting on this roster. You look at the additions that they've made so far in free agency. You look at Lonnie Walker, Juan Toscano-Anderson, Troy Brown Jr., Damian Jones. No shooting there. You look at the guys they brought back. You've got Austin Reeves, who we've got some hope can become a better shooter, but 31% from three last season. Now, again, he's been putting in a lot of work in the offseason, but still 31% last season. Same thing with Stanley Johnson. Wenyen Gabriel didn't shoot the ball well. Those are the guys the Lakers are bringing back on top of LeBron James, who right now is probably the team's best three-point shooter. Anthony Davis shot, what, 18% from three last season. Russell Westbrook gets ignored behind the three-point line. So clearly, the Lakers need more shooting. Talen Horton-Tucker is going to work on a shot, but they don't have anybody right now who is a consistent, steady three-point threat that other teams are going to really, really worry about. And I don't necessarily think that's the worst thing here, right? When you look at this roster build, as of right now, they have a lot of guys who can defend. And okay, Lonnie Walker maybe needs to do some work there. But you have a lot of guys who can defend, who are young, who bring energy, and they can at least be respectable behind the arc. And I think that's fine. That's really all that you need. You don't, the difference between a guy who shoots 40% from three and a guy who shoots 35% from three isn't that much in terms of what the defense does. That's really what three-point shooting is about. It's what you can make the defense do. Does the defense care that you're out there behind the three-point line? And if you are a guy who's willing to pull the trigger and can shoot league average 35, 36% from three, that's usually enough to stretch a defense. So I'm okay with what the Lakers have done so far, but you have to be careful, because if any of these guys see that Lakers drop in three-point percentage, that weird thing that seems to happen when somebody puts on the purple and gold, their three-point percentage tends to come down. If that happens, you could put yourself into the danger zone where suddenly teams don't care if a guy like a Stanley Johnson is behind the three-point line, or perhaps a Lonnie Walker, or whoever it is that's out there. If their percentages come down at all, then opposing teams no longer guard them. The paint is packed, and that creates more problems. We saw a lot of that last season. So plan B for the Lakers, according to Dave McMenamin, could very well be Eric Gordon or our old friend, Buddy Hield. That's right, the one that got away. So how do the Lakers do this? First and foremost, both make sense as targets. Buddy Hield, a little bit younger, but he's not as young as you would think. 29 years old. He came into the NBA as an older rookie, but both of these guys can provide plenty of shooting. Eric Gordon provides a little bit of playmaking as well. Interesting targets, both of them making about $20 million though. But the rumor was, when the Lakers started putting this roster together and people started saying, hey, where's the shooting? What are you going to do here? How is this going to work? The rumor that came out was the Lakers were confident that they could address the shooting concern via trade, and they didn't want to pay the going rate in free agency to get shooting. So that means that even if this Kyrie thing doesn't go down, moves are coming. So how do you get to Eric Gordon or Buddy Hield? The way it has to happen is you're stacking up Talen Horton-Tucker. Now, assuming that both of those teams, the Houston Rockets and Pacers, do not want Russell Westbrook, because then you can maybe work out something bigger there. But otherwise, you're stacking up Talen Horton-Tucker, Kendrick Nunn, and something. That's right. It has to be a 3-for-1 trade, because Talen Horton-Tucker and Kendrick Nunn, their salaries aren't enough to even out the scales when you've got an Eric Gordon or you've got a Buddy Hield coming back. So instead, we're talking about Talen Horton-Tucker, Kendrick Nunn, and then a contract, could be like a Wenyen Gabriel, someone like that, added in as well. And then the question becomes, do the Lakers need to put in anything on top of that? Does Taylor Horton Tucker, as a young player, have enough value despite having a player option next summer to get these teams to bite on something like that? Or do the Lakers have to put in, maybe it's a future pick swap, maybe it's a future first, maybe it's seconds, whatever it is, I think the Lakers are going to have to add some value to that and hope that those teams, the Rockets and, of course, the Pacers, are in a position where they're okay with taking back three players and sending out one. So I don't think this is necessarily an easy swap if this is truly the fallback plan for the Lakers, but it does make a lot of sense in terms of a target for either of those guys to wind up in purple and gold and give you a little bit of floor spacing, which is badly needed right now. Lastly, depending on what they do with their remaining roster spots, remember right now they've only got a couple of spots still remaining. Now, again, that can change very quickly if they do a 3-for-1 trade. But as of this moment, if it's just Buddy Hield or just Eric Gordon, that's putting a lot on that player to be your real main source of floor spacing. And that could prove to be problematic. I mean, look, last season, the Lakers went in with Trevor Ariza as essentially their only option as a wing defender. And then he winds up having ankle surgery and then you don't have that. And they badly, badly needed that. That's what, you know, part of what got Stanley Johnson the opportunity to come on board midway through the season is because the Lakers had put all their chips into that basket. Trevor Ariza, he's going to be maybe a starter, definitely going to be the wing defender that we lean upon to be that switchy guy out there. Well, didn't work out because that guy wound up getting hurt. So if you are just getting Eric Gordon or just getting Buddy Hield, that's putting a lot on that one player to be your only source of consistent three-point shooting. So I do think that they need to have a fallback to the fallback, as it were, where they need to add a little bit more shooting in addition to one of those guys. But again, maybe a Kyrie Irving trade gets worked out. And what we've heard so far, the framework could look like Kyrie Irving, Joe Harris in exchange for Russell Westbrook, THT, and stuff. Well, however many picks or whatever it is that gets added in. And if that's the case, then you're probably okay in the shooting department. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Let me know what you think about Eric Gordon and Buddy Hield as potential fallback options for the Lakers in case the Kyrie Irving trade does not get done. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see you.